steht in Seir, wo das kann jeder, er guckt an ihn wenig, als in Schnaar schisch mir jes le jelle faschischi, is a dämmelt is, werden geöffnet werden, ma jonis, ut heim rabo, als it nis rabe werden, chochme boilom, und der Seher Redor befehrischt nie dafke wegen Chochme von Tero Velikus, nos rätsach wegen Chochme Stan.
In 1963, we were actually at that time starting to look for life on Mars. And the Rebbe was terribly interested in that. On our very first meeting, I said, you know, there are those, and I used the word, there are those of your followers who say that a Jew should not be working in the space biology program, the exobiology program, because it goes contrary to Torah. The Rebbe stopped. One of those beautiful moments in time. He didn't smile. And he just thought. And then he came back with this and he said as follows, exactly the way I'm doing it. He pointed at me. He was saying this in Yiddish. You should look for life on Mars. You should keep looking. Keep looking for life on Mars. And if you don't find it, keep looking elsewhere. And elsewhere. And keep looking, because to sit here in this world and you say there is no life elsewhere is to put a limit around what God can do, and that nobody can do. Now the Rebbe didn't say there was life on Mars. The Rebbe just said that the job of a scientist who is trained in that profession is to keep looking for it.
Und mit dort nicht gleich Messiah, mit was wird er das jetzt losen, als alle werden anerkennen, der Minion von Wehäusala, als Shem Hamlucho, der Minion von Hawaii, Chod und Schmeier Chod. Das ist ein Leike, das hat Teim. Als Koch mit Schizenis bringen Reis auf Heber von Gdusche, nur Adra, bei was mehr, mir weiß das Lamitosom, als mehrer kommt der Hechrech, als es echot beoretz, hat die ganze Welt durchgenommen geworden, mit einische Lachdus.
The Rebbe had written a famous letter on evolution. So once in one of our discussions that I had with Moshe Feller, already close to Moshe Feller, I had a negative approach to it. I thought it was a little, it wasn't adequate. It was too thin, it was too threadbare. And I told that to Moshe. It's not a great letter. Why don't you write the Rebbe and tell him that? He said, well, I'm not going to write to the Rebbe. I saw the Rebbe. I consider him to be the Navi of our people before anything else. He's a Navi. I'm going to write him. He'd like to hear from you. You know, dear Rabbi Schneerson, I saw this and this, and I have the following criticism to make about it. It was common to make about it. The Rebbe answered, but he never turned to the question that I wrote in this particular letter. So I wrote back another letter. You didn't answer the question originally, which means, obviously, that you agree with my point of view. There's one letter that the Rebbe writes in which he says, essentially, it is not my job to win arguments. My job is to prevent the Jewish point of view and win adherence to the Jewish cause. And if I were to take issue with you on that letter, I might have pushed you away. But now that I see that you and your wife, I will return. And he goes ahead and answers the letter with a reasonable explanation. But I saw something extremely important in that letter. The Rebbe is demanding from scientists to teach science properly. In other words, to keep science from becoming a dogma. Science is a subject that must deal with probabilities rather than absolutes. He told me he studied mathematics in Berlin, and he studied engineering in Paris. And he said that his only desire in his debates and discussions with other scientists was to be honest, to present the point of view. And even with regard to the concept of the motions of the stars and the motions of the solar system and so forth, he said, to be honest, you must teach that prior to the Copernican theory, there was a Ptolemaic theory. After the Copernican theory, there'll be another theory, a good, maybe a better. We're always trying to get closer to the truth. So This attracted me very, very much to him.
Rado sagt, was ist einen in Gräse Spoilers von die Entdeckungen, was sie da in Hochmischizene ist, beschon im Achrenes. Was beklall ist, als das Song gegeben in die letzte etliche Zendlik Jahr. Und das Asach, was sehen Chod, der Stachas Hashemesh.
The Rebbe was once talking, what is a black hole? Black hole was once a sun. It was once a body in the heaven that was burning like our sun, with hydrogen burning and providing light and heat excessively. And then over time, the fire went out, and then the mass collapsed on itself. And now the mag, it becomes very, very dense, very, very heavy. And it's so collapsed on itself that no light is emitted, and light that passes through it is retained, nothing is spared. The Rebbe once referred to Jewish college professors as a black hole. At one time, they could have been light. They could have been a source of light and illumination, but they've collapsed on themselves to such an extent that not only do they not give any light, but any light that goes through them is absorbed.
Wo der Fund kommt mir nach Reis zu der Kennen, in wo sie der Ingen se darf sein, die Milchomo bei der Reino se. Und das ist ein Dor, was mir hat ihm gegeben als eine Möglichkeit, was er noch keinmal nicht gewöhnt, und bei wenn ich sehe noch ein Rabbi. Und noch mehr, der Lezar, Hachi Godel, nichts mit den Möglichkeiten legamre nicht ist.
He said, did Rabbi Feller ever tell me what the Baal Shem Tov meant by Hashgacha Pratis, or Divine Providence? So I said, yes. Now the principle of Divine Providence that the Baal Shem Tov taught is that everything that a Jew sees and hears is not by accident, and it's not random, but is designed by heaven itself to bring you closer to Torah and to God. If this is true for everybody, how much more true for a person who works in a field like exploration of the stratosphere and traveling all over the world and meeting so many people? He said, you must have a wealth of stories and anecdotes and events and impressions, each one of them which has a special Hashgacha Pratis. Keep a journal, keep a record of these stories and the events. And then try and analyze to see what is the Hashgacha Pratis, what is the lesson you learn from these things. And if you can't do it by yourself, come and bring them to me, and I'll work with you.